Welcome to Björn Press Channel.
Hello.
Those Fidget spinners are still trending strong.
And we like trending videos.
And I watched a video from Scott Manlev. I add link in the description. And he calculated how fast these could spin before they explode. And it was something around 20,000 revolutions per minute. So I made this. This spins 32,000 revolutions per minute, so it's quite fast. And I have now really low pressure on the line. Yeah, but it's still quite fast. And we tested this with a spinner like that yesterday, and it exploded almost like 1 second into the spinning. And I think it was too poor result for video. We want something bit better. So we have this really weak ass spinner, this medium strength spinner,
medium ass spinner,
medium, and then we have this
heavy ass
spinner. And all of these are 3D printed with PLA, so it's probably not as strong as something that you can buy from store, because stores are probably ABS or something like that, and I didn't have any ABS right now. But we made, I think this is probably the closest that you can buy from the store as in the dimensions, and this is much more, and this is
fast.
This is much more, this is going to take much more speed than anything else that you can, that is made out of plastic and it's spinner. So I think we are going to get some interesting result. And the idea is to spin all the spinners inside this blast chamber. It's really high tech. And film spinning motion with Chronos, so we can see how they break, and then we can see on what speed they break. So it should be really interesting. And I think we are going to move up from the weakest to the strongest.
Yeah.
And let's hope that they all explode. And let's hope that this is enough. Because I do calculations here, but the outer diameter of this is going to move very fast at the full speed. So when this breaks, all the parts are traveling really fast and they are really dangerous. And wearing safety glasses isn't enough, so that's why we are using this. And I'm also going to use high-tech remote control, so we are completely safe. So everything is now ready. Spinner is ready and high-speed cameras and everything is running. And first one is the weak one. And I have high pressure, so it's going to be really fast. Yeah, but yeah, let's see.
Quite fast!
Pretty good! And they are...
Oh my!
I think we are in trouble with those harder ones.
Yep.
Yeah, I think we have to change this, because here is hole. Oh. Even with the weak-ass spinner, there is goddamn hole in the sheet metal. We have to get a bit thicker one. So that was pretty good. And I did some calculations. I had 4400 frames per second on the camera. And it was about 14 frames to one revolution. And that gives us 315 revolutions per second, and that is almost 1900 revolutions per minute. So that was pretty damn close to those calculations that Scott made. 1,000 off. So it's really amazing. Really, really fucking
amazing. It works.
Yeah, it really works. Math works. Who would know? Yeah. But I think we have to test at least the medium spinner. I think the heavy one.
I want big also.
Yeah. My guess is that we can explode medium one and the big one will survive.
No. Big one will explode also.
Yeah. Let's see. Yeah, everything is ready for the new one. And now I put some ballistic gelatin also there. So we would see the like damage that spinner explosion does to the autistic kid that is using it. So let's see. And here we go. That was pretty good. I checked the slow motion, so I did some calculations and it was 13 frames for one revolutions, and that puts it a bit over 20,000 revolutions per minute, so not that much faster. And on the slow motion you could see the one bearing flying to the ballistic gelatin and hit it here, and there isn't any like deep hole, there is small cut, about maybe 3 millimeters, but I think it would been hurt, but I think it would hurt that really much, because it was about one or two inches inside of this with the impact, so it is quite hard hit. Yeah, but let's explore the and here are some shrapnel. This is totally okay. I think this might be the part that went into the gelatin, because it's quite soft. And this is probably hit to the steel plate, because even the bearing is broken. And you have to toss this quite fast to get this broke like this. And then the hardest one. And here we go.
The building.
So we find it here, or then we have to go to the roof.
Or to Nate Force Yard.
Or then we have to take our drone up and use it to find that. It might be also on the roof. So we are going to the roof. And to information for you all, my leg is hurting because I stepped on some spike yesterday. It isn't anything related to the channel. So I am on the roof now. And yeah, here it is! Yes! And it is missing one part. And there is some dent. Anne, Come take this. I throw it on the grass. Yeah. Anni, come hold the ladder when I go down. Yeah, I think once more time our safety precautions weren't at like top level, and I think we are not going to continue this more here.
No.
I think if I could find better pneumatic tool that spins faster, and we would take the whole thing to the countryside and do without this, that might be one option. But here in the city and with these tools, I think this is the best that we can do. And the heavy one, when it like releases itself, it's spinning about 21,000 revolutions per minute. I have to check the tape for it. Was the speed already stable? So was it the top speed with this and that tool? Or was it still accelerating? But I think it took so long that at least it wasn't accelerating very much anymore. And yeah, this survives the 20,000 revolutions per minute if the bearing holds here. But because it's 3D printed and not very like precise, it's with fast setup, there is always some unbalances, so it was vibrating really lot, and probably that loosened the bearing, and then it got loose. Because these are really tight, you have to hammer them in or use your press to install them, so they are not coming like out of here with hand. Yeah, but 20,000 revolutions per minute. Scott, you were right.
Yep.
Good math. And I think the math part is a bit easier and not as dangerous as this. Yeah, but I think that is all for today.
Thank you for watching.
And have a nice day.